Welcome to the Arsis channel! Good day! I'm your pharmacist at your service.
People move. But why? How? Did you ever wonder what's happening inside of our body? Oh, the blood flow. Have you ever wondered how important it is? Let's watch this. The muscle, which is made up of cells, can move because of energy. Energy in the form of ATP can be made through the use of oxygen. This is through the process called cellular respiration. As a waste product of this process, carbon dioxide is produced. This waste product will later on be carried by blood for disposal through exhalation. Oxygen-rich blood replenishes the oxygen lost by the muscle cells during cellular respiration. In exchange of the cell's waste product, carbon dioxide. This exchange of gases fuels the continuous process of cellular respiration inside the cell. This blood, which is rich in carbon dioxide, needs to deliver this carbon dioxide to the lungs by passing through the heart. During normal condition, this oxygen-poor blood moves because of several factors, which includes continuous pumping of the heart, or due to the movement of body during swimming, walking, jogging, and other daily activities of a person. Now, let me introduce to you the heart. The heart has four chambers, namely the right atrium, the right ventricle, the left atrium, and the left ventricle. The right atrium and the right ventricle holds and pumps oxygen-poor blood, while your left atrium and left ventricle holds and pumps oxygen-rich blood. So the heart also has valves, namely the tricuspid valve, the pulmonary valve, the aortic valve, and the mitral valve. These valves are responsible for preventing the backflow of blood while the ventricles of the heart are pumping. The heart also has blood vessels. These blood vessels carry oxygen-rich blood and oxygen-poor blood, like the superior and inferior vena cava, together with the left and right pulmonary artery, the aorta, and the left and right pulmonary vein. Superior vena cava, pulmonary artery, and the inferior vena cava carries and delivers oxygen-poor blood, while the aorta and pulmonary vein carries and delivers oxygen-rich blood. Going back, oxygen-poor blood from superior and inferior vena cava will be received by the right atrium. Tricuspid valve will open to reach the right ventricle. Right ventricle will pump this blood to the pulmonary artery going to the lungs. The lungs is responsible for respiration, inhalation of oxygen, and exhalation of carbon dioxide. This continuous process happens while we are breathing, while we are still alive. Inside these lungs are alveoli. This alveoli contains capillary on where there is an exchange of gases like carbon dioxide and oxygen. So inside of that, the blood will now give off the carbon dioxide and will receive oxygen. Thus, this blood will become oxygen-rich blood. This oxygen-rich blood will be received by the left atrium going to the left ventricle, pump into the aorta, in order for it to be distributed in other parts of the body that needs oxygen. So this blood will now distribute its oxygen and collects carbon dioxide to every cell of the body. But, oops, oh,
lobes.
Oh, there is a blockade. A fat blockade. What would happen now? What would happen to the oxygen? What would happen to the cell? What would happen to every cell of the body if they will not receive oxygen? Will cellular respiration still occur? What will happen to the waste product of cellular respiration?
Thank you for sharing your love by clicking the like button and the subscribe button below. Once again, I'm your pharmacist at your service.